Hello, everybody. Andrea here. So let's talk about how billing is done. So billing scale units, billing polishing units, the ReCare exam, a specific exam, how does all of that work exactly? So I am a mobile dental hygienist. So what I do is I bill for my time. It's plain and simple. I bill for my time. Now for mobile hygiene, it is a little bit different because there will always be 20 minutes setup time and 20 minutes teardown time. So I book an extra hour for that in case I'm, you know, talking to my patient a little bit more. Maybe it takes me an extra trip to load up the car, put it back, you know, who knows. But I tell somebody the cleaning is going to be about an hour, give or take. And let's just book another hour for cleaning and setup time. I'll probably be done earlier. So I book 2 hours per person. If I'm seeing, let's say, two people in the same household, then I'll book 3 hours, that kind of thing. But you might be wondering, okay, am I charging 2 hours worth of scale units, polishing units, exam for that? No, I'm not. So the teardown and setup time, I bill a mobile fee for that. So it really depends on where I'm traveling, but typically a mobile fee for me is $20. Sometimes that's covered by insurance, sometimes it's not, but it's absolutely important, imperative for me to do that because $20 isn't just a mobile fee to me. $20 is the wear and tear that's happening on my car to travel, plus all of the work I'm doing, loading up everything, and the convenience for the person. People pay for convenience. I'm not charging $100 for a mobile fee, I'm charging $20. So I feel that that's absolutely fair. Comment below and let me know what you think. How much do you feel is fair for a mobile fee? Let me know. In the fee guide, it kind of ranges for up to $80, but I just kind of felt that that was too high. Anyway, so talking more about scaling and polishing units. So if I'm seeing a patient for 1 hour, I typically book, depending on what I'm doing, at least 3 units of scale, sometimes 4 units, because 4 units is 1 hour. 3 units is 45 minutes, right? But I will also include polishing, the ReCare exam, or depending what I'm doing, a specific exam on top of that. I typically give a fluoride varnish and depending on what else is needed. So if I'm seeing a child, for example, and their appointment's half an hour, if that time, if I did pick up a scaler, of course, which I do usually do for children because it's much easier to take plaque away sometimes with a scaler than it is to polish the teeth. You get better results. So depending on how long I spent with that child, I might still bill 2 units of scaling because 1 unit here in Ontario is 15 minutes. Okay. Some people say 10 minutes. It depends on their computer software that they're using. In the fee guide, it's 15 minutes. Charge for your time. This is where pricing and dental offices really does vary because they're so used to only charging, say, 1 unit of scale per person. Their patients are used to that, so they're not going to pay more. Or on the opposite side of things, they're used to charging 3 units of scale for everybody, no matter how much time they spend. So it really does depend on time, you guys. Keep that in mind. You would not see a child for half an hour and bill 4 units of scale. That doesn't make sense, right? I also take into account any, like, was this more complicated? Did they have black, tenacious tartar where I had to set up my piezo, my compressor unit with the air, the water, the suction? Maybe not. If I didn't have to set all of that up and take the extra time, that's going to be less scaling units. So charge for that time. The rule of thumb is we charge our patients from the time we seat them down, talking about treatment, talking about medical history, to even the time that we're tidying up. So it really does depend on how you want to do that. But I just kind of explained how I did it. Typically, it's 3 to 4 units for an adult patient. It might even be 2 units of scale for a child. Depends what I'm doing. I hope I made that clear. Comment below if you guys have any other questions. And I should mention I'm in Ontario, so I'm kind of talking specific to Ontario here, but this probably applies to everybody else too, international. If you click the video thinking, I want to know, what does she charge for units of time? So thank you guys for listening. Click like if you like the video. I love doing them, and I'm trying to think of lots of different topics to kind of talk about because you guys love them, which is fantastic. Thank you for watching, you guys.